Welcome to In the Spotlight with the Minnesota Magicians, another edition. I'm Jimmy Lilladahl, Director of Media Relations and Broadcasting for the Minnesota Magicians. As the expansion continues, we'll talk about the recap of this weekend. We'll talk about some things coming up in the schedule here in the near future. We'll kind of preview the 9-game homestand coming up in November. 850 fans showed up this weekend, this Saturday against the Fairbanks Ice Dogs. It was a great turnout. In the first period, Fairbanks gets a goal just a minute and 9 seconds in, kind of a turnover in front of the Minnesota Magicians net, and Fairbanks was able to capitalize. They were able to cash in twice in the first 5 minutes. The first period, the Ice Dogs were able to outshoot the Magicians 16-6. So it was kind of a lopsided period. Going into the second period, the Magicians able to get a little bit of a momentum. Fairbanks did take a 3-0 lead 4 minutes into that second period, but the Magicians get a big goal from Nick Kuchera. Colin Hernan gets the helper on that. So a big goal for Nick Kuchera as he adds another here for the Minnesota Magicians. Then it's a questionable penalty in the second period. That was kind of a reoccurring theme over the weekend. A lot of penalties in Saturday night's game. Kyle Lee gets a power play goal for Fairbanks. So with a 3-1 score, the Magicians get another goal. This time it's E2 Karvonen set up by Tony Uglum off the far wall. Actually, Tony Uglum getting the assist on his birthday, so a nice situation for Tony Uglum is he's able to set up E2 Karvonen, and you see the highlight. E2 able to dance in front of the net, find some space, and the Finnish native able to get another goal. E2 Karvonen continues to put up points for the Minnesota Magicians. In the third period, there wasn't as much going on. Just a combined 14 shots for both teams with 7 shots in that third period. The penalties continued in that third period. There was over an hour combined penalty minutes in the game, so a lot of penalties. Again, both teams just 7 shots in that final frame, and Fairbanks able to come out with a 4-2 victory. Welcome back to In the Spotlight with the Minnesota Magicians. I'm Jimmy Lilladahl alongside rookie forward here, Mario Bianchi. Mario, no stranger to these here parts. You played 4 years at the Academy of Holy Angels. Now you're playing with the red and black.
Yeah, it's really exciting. The rink's definitely gotten a makeover. It looks real nice, and it's fun to play in for sure.
Talk about a little bit of your rookie campaign here. You scored the first ever goal for the Minnesota Magicians at the showcase. That was huge. Talk about the energy that gave you in that day.
Yeah, it definitely gave me a lot of confidence. It was really exciting. The showcase was packed with scouts. I was lucky enough to get a breakaway and put it in, and it's definitely helped me so far this year.
Talk a little bit about playing with Jack Weiss and then Colin Hernan. I know you're the 3 Bloomington products. A lot of fans coming out to watch them, the local kids. What's it like playing with Colin Hernan and Jack Weiss? I know you're really good friends with those guys and you grew up with them.
Yeah, well, I played youth hockey and summer hockey growing up with them a lot. I built really great relationships with both of them and took a couple years off with high school, but I'm really excited to finish out the year with them. I've become even better friends with them. And it's been a blast, just hanging out with the guys and meeting new people as well.
This weekend it was the Fairbanks Ice Dogs, a very talented team. We talked to the broadcast a little bit. 4 Division I commitments. They had close to 10 last year, a very competitive team. Talk a little bit about what happened here on Saturday.
Well, they came out flying. You could tell they really mesh well together. They play the system really well, and it's something that we're going to see a lot. I think we're going to play them a couple more times, and hopefully we can take what we learned this past weekend and use that in the future against them.
In the spotlight here, I'm Jimmy Lilladahl alongside rookie forward Mario Bianchi. Mario, before we go here, talk about the road trip. We're in the Midwest Division. We got to go to Kenai, Alaska, Fairbanks, Alaska, Springfield, Illinois, Janesville, Wisconsin, plenty of locations. We play 14 different teams, 9 different states, more than the majority of the North American Hockey League teams. This weekend, it's a 3-piece in Janesville, Wisconsin. First roadie with the boys.
I think it's going to be a lot of fun. It'll be one of the longest bus trips I've taken. Should be exciting to play in some new arenas, see some new teams. I'm really looking forward to it.
Mario, thanks for taking the time.
Yeah, thank you, Jimmy.
That's Mario Bianchi of the Minnesota Magicians. Welcome back to In the Spotlight with the Minnesota Magicians. A big thanks to Mario Bianchi for taking the time to stop by and speak with us, talking about some of the upcoming events here at the Richfield Ice Arena and with the Minnesota Magicians in general. I want to thank Champs for the beer sales, doing an excellent job. Again, beer is available, so make sure you come out to Richfield Ice Arena and check that out. Again, 9 home games in November, playing a bunch of different teams from a couple different divisions, so make sure you come out for that. Corporate partnerships are still available. 612-861-9356 if you're interested. All games are available on fasthockey.com. The Magicians play a three-piece against the Janesville Jets this weekend. You can join the broadcast. You can even send an email during the broadcast if you want to join us in the booth. Jimmy@MinnesotaMagicians.com. Also, the 9-game homestand. Some of the teams that we're going to be playing here at the Richfield Ice Arena, plenty of them. The Janesville Jets, the Aberdeen Wings, the Minot Minotauros, as well as the Brookings Blizzard, and then the Magicians will conclude the road trip against the Cooley Region Chill, a team they beat 5-1 last weekend. So make sure you check that out. Again, tickets are available at magicianshockey.com, and make sure you give us a follow on Twitter at MNMagiciansNAHL. And the next home game is here against Janesville, so make sure you check that out. That's a weekend away right here at the Richfield Ice Arena. That's going to do it for the second installment of In the Spotlight with the Minnesota Magicians. So long, everybody.